So a few months ago, these teachers came along to Western Sydney University and took part in a professional learning program that introduced them to the idea of inquiry-based learning, but also to the Sydney Metro project.
The thing is that students have high expectations of themselves, and so how...
Working with Sydney Metro and with Western Sydney University have been fantastic because we've had the opportunity to do something we haven't been able to do before with this inquiry-based learning project, and having some experts come in from Sydney Metro and being able to actually get them in and talk to the kids first hand and face to face and engage them in what the Metro project is all about has really made a big difference for the project. I think it's really important to teach STEM in schools. Prior to being a teacher, I actually was a computer science person, so I'm really passionate about teaching digital technology and science, technology, engineering and maths. So especially for those students and going forward into the future with everything changing so much with our jobs, it's really important that we engage the students and we actually teach them those STEM skills.
I love design, shapes, 3D, mathematics, STEM. I love stuff like that. I really wanted to figure out why. Why were they making new trends? Why were they doing that? And our project was to discover how.
I would definitely recommend this opportunity to any other school because of the authenticity and the fact that the children looking at a purpose, because a lot of them were saying, I now get on a train and I understand what goes on in a train.
The start, we came in and given some guidance on what questions to ask. They've gone away, thought about those questions, and they're here today to present to us, and they've come up with some great presentations, great ideas, really sort of left to centre ideas that you wouldn't think about, so it's really great to see. Tell me about how Sydney Metro is going to get safety and ensure safety for the passengers.
Instead of having a yellow line to not cross the yellow line to get too close to the train, there are glass barriers, and today you'll be seeing a presentation that includes a Minecraft boring machine.
I think the excitement is I've seen the journey happening. I've seen how the children have gone into groups and how they've been collaborative and how they've had to choose the topics of what they wanted to investigate in their inquiry-based project. But what I saw today was a culmination of the richness of the processes of the inquiry-based learning.
When I walked around today, I saw nothing but excitement on the kids' faces, and sometimes when we do our presentations in the classroom, they're very reluctant to get up and present in front of others, and today I saw a completely different side. I saw them really engaged, really happy to have an audience to speak to people and to show their product, to show their Minecraft worlds, to show their videos.
Look, I think what we see here today tells me that this program is a success. If I see children who are producing really good work and teachers who are also getting engaged about teaching through an inquiry-based approach, that to me is success.